Hello Year 4, welcome to Wednesday's English lesson. Today we're going to be writing expanded noun phrases, getting ourselves ready to do a piece of writing tomorrow on a scene from the story. To start with, I want you to just have a look at the sentence on the screen. The blonde girl with grey trousers walked across the grass. Can you identify any of the words? Can you see a verb? Can you see an adjective? Are there more than one adjectives? Can you see a noun, a preposition, a determiner? Before moving on, see if you can identify each of those types of words. I have color-coded those words for you. If any of them surprise you, or if you weren't sure of any of them, I'd like you to just go and remind yourself of these different word types before moving on. Now we've identified each of the words, are you able to identify the expanded noun phrase in this sentence? Remember, an expanded noun phrase is one or more words that describe a noun. Which noun do you think is being described, and which part of this sentence is describing that noun? Fantastic, that's right. The girl is the noun that is being described. So the noun phrase is the blonde girl with grey trousers. That's because the grey trousers is still describing the girl. It's what she's wearing. So keep in mind, an expanded noun phrase is describing the one noun with more than one word. So although blonde is the adjective before girl, with grey trousers is still describing the girl. Now we've reminded ourselves of what expanded noun phrases are, I want you to take some time to choose a page from the story that you want to describe. Tomorrow you're going to write a description of the scene that you are looking at. So I want you to look through all the pictures again and think to yourself which one would be best to describe in a paragraph of writing. I have chosen the scene from the Moroccan market. That's because there's lots of things happening and there's lots of different things to describe. You can choose any picture. This is just the one that I'm going to use as my example for today. To choose a picture, you'll want to go back to yesterday's video. Make sure to pause it on the picture that you want and keep that open on the screen. An alternative is to ask an adult to print screen the image and to print it out for you so that you have it in front of you all the time if you can't keep the computer in front of you for the rest of the lesson. Once you've got your picture, the first thing to do is to write down all of the things that you can see. So that's all of the nouns. You can see what I've done is drawn arrows to each of them. If you haven't got your picture in front of you, you could just write a list of all of the nouns on a page. You can see that I haven't done all of the things on my picture. I've done the things that I want to describe in my writing tomorrow. But if you'd like to, you could go through and write all of the nouns that you can see so that you have as many options as you want for later. The next thing I want you to do is next to each of the nouns, or in your book as a list, write at least one adjective to go with each of those nouns. The more the better, because that will give you more to write about. Some of the nouns that you've chosen will obviously go with other nouns. For example, I've chosen man and bag, although the man has a bag on his head, so those two will actually end up going together. Maybe you want to think about which nouns you've chosen which could go together in a sentence. Make sure you do write at least one adjective for each of those nouns. If you end up having more than one adjective but don't use them, it's better than having none and wanting to use one. Make sure you're looking at the picture while you're thinking of these adjectives. Describe what you see rather than what you think should be there. You might want to describe what it would smell like or what you would hear or how you would feel rather than just what you see. But for now, I've just gone with things that I can see. The last step to create our noun phrases is to put these nouns and adjectives together and maybe use a preposition to add more information. To help you see what I've done, I have color-coded my work. You can see that I have put an arrow to the noun that I was describing, and I have made sure that I am just describing that noun. So if we have a look at the first one, vegetables is what I'm describing. Many colorful vegetables on top of a thin, ragged carpet. So what is on top of the thin, ragged carpet? That's the vegetables that I mentioned at the beginning. My second one, where I've combined two different nouns, I'm still describing the man the whole way through that phrase, despite the fact that I've added bag as well. So a tall, strong man with a small white bag on his head. So you can see that with a small white bag on his head is still describing what the man is doing. Your task today is to make sure that you have written at least 10 expanded noun phrases. This will be a great start for your work tomorrow. You'll already have 10 sentence starters to get you going to write your description. Remember to keep that picture in front of you and always refer back to it. Don't start describing something that isn't there. If you have done all 10 of your expanded noun phrases and would like an extra challenge, the next thing you could do is write a fronted adverbial for each of your noun phrases. So you can see I have used a tall, strong man with a small white bag on his head. And I need to think of a fronted adverbial which describes when, where, or how that happens. I've chosen where that happens. So at the beginning of my sentence, I've put in the middle of the market, comma, stands a tall, strong man with a small white bag on his head. You can see I've had to add stands so that the sentence makes sense. So if you finished your expanded noun phrases, you can write some fronted adverbials and you'll be well on your way to writing your paragraph tomorrow. That's all I've got for you today. I hope you have a fantastic rest of your day and I will speak to you tomorrow. Goodbye.